Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here, and in this video, we're going to be discussing variables in C++. Let's get into it. Do you guys remember in math class in school where there was an equation such as this, and you can solve for what the value of x is, and then you can reuse x as if it were that actual number? Like here, in our example, x equals 2, and then if we use this in another equation, x behaves as if it's the number 2, and we can produce a result. So for all intents and purposes, our variable here could store some sort of value, and it will behave as the value that it contains. And we can reuse those variables elsewhere in our C++ programs. However, we are not limited to only assigning numbers to variables. We can also assign words, single characters, or even these things called Boolean values, which hold either true or false. Heck, we can even assign entire sentences to a variable. Now, these are the steps to create a variable in C++. The first is that you need to come up with a name. Let's pick something simple to begin with, such as x, just because we're used to using x, like in math class. We'll say x equals, and then we can give it a number if we wanted to. Let's say 2020, and then finish this with a semicolon. Alright, so there's one more step that we need. We need to declare what type of value that this variable is going to hold. So there's certain rules that apply when declaring variables, and if this variable is going to store a value of some sort, we have to declare what type of value that is going to be stored within this variable. For example, this could be a whole integer, a decimal value, a single character, a string that's like a series of characters, like a word, a Boolean value, etc. So for example, if we wanted to store a whole integer value, we would have to declare this of the int data type, which is short for integer. But there's other data types that we should cover. So let's discuss what those data types are. Now, before we really begin to discuss data types, these are only a few of the data types that are available to us. I'm only going to be covering a few of the basic ones just because they can get somewhat complex, but I want to give you just enough information to get started with using data types. And then as you understand how these work, you can look at other data types to see what would suit your needs. So to begin, let's discuss the integer data type. This will only store a whole number. An example would be an age or a year. Like, you couldn't store a decimal value within here. Like, you wouldn't say, for like a year, you wouldn't say it's like the year 2020.5. I guess for an age though, if you're a young kid, you might say like, I'm 7.5 years old, but typically people don't put like a decimal in their age. So if you want to declare a variable of the integer data type, you just write int before the variable name. A double will store a decimal. An example would be a price, and you just write double before the variable name. And the reason that this is named double, it has to do with double floating point precision. It relates to computer science, but think of double as a decimal. So you can store something such as a price, anything that contains a decimal portion. The character data type, sometimes referred to as char, like you're pronouncing Charizard, will hold a single character, like a letter or a symbol. A string, that can hold one or more characters. An example would be somebody's name, or even an entire sentence or a paragraph. And this also has the capability of holding a single character, but we treat strings and characters differently. And we also have Boolean, which can hold either a true or false. And this is useful if you need to verify if something's correct or not, if something's on or off. And to declare something of the Boolean data type, you just write B-O-O-L before the variable name. Now remember, these are only a few of the most commonly used data types that would be used for beginners, so there's definitely more out there, just so you're aware, but these are a few just to get us started. Let's head back to our program. Now, if we want to store a whole integer within a variable, we have to declare this of the integer data type, and according to that cheat sheet, we had to place int here for integer. Now we can reuse this variable as if it was this number. We can actually display this if we really wanted to. We'll use our display method cout, and then we'll just place x here. Now we don't need to put anything within double quotes because that will literally print something. So we can just reuse x, and then I'm forgetting that semicolon at the end. All right, let's display this. And here is our result, 2020. Now, when naming variables, it's important to name it something that will help you and other people identify what this is. The letter X isn't too descriptive. We can rename this something perhaps as year, and that's much more descriptive, and we will have to change it here as well. So you're not limited to just having a variable named X. You can name it other things too, like year is more descriptive of what kind of value that this variable will contain, and this will work just the same as it did before, despite the name change. How about we create a couple more variables, and let's have them all be related to, how about cars? I like cars. So let's create a few variables based on the data types that we just learned about. So if we want a price, we can use a double value because that can hold a decimal. So we'll say double, and then we'll create a variable named price, equals, and then we can assign a decimal value here. So $9,999.99 sounds pretty good to me. I'm thinking for our next variable, we can assign a char value, a single character, so we need to say char. And then how about a status, like is our car new or is it used? So we'll say status equals, and then if you're assigning a char value, you need to put it within single quotes. And you can put any one character in here, doesn't matter which one. So how about we say N for new, U for used? So that would work. We need a string still, so how about a model of a car? So we'll say string, and then model equals, and then if you're assigning a string, you need it within double quotes. So pay attention that with integers, you don't need any quotes, same with doubles. For char values, you need single quotes. Strings, you need double quotes. So I'll pick my favorite car, which is a Mustang. And lastly, we could use a Boolean value. So we'll say B-O-O-L, short for Boolean. And how about we create a variable named for sale? Like, is the car for sale? True or false? Yes or no? So we can say, you know, true if it is, or false if it isn't, but I want this car to be for sale, so I'll say true. So there we go. We have successfully created 5 different variables, and now we can reuse these variables elsewhere in our program. And we can display these variables much like we did with the year. However, if we're going to be displaying multiple variables, we probably want to separate these by line. So actually, I'm going to add ENDL at the end of this, just so we can move each of these variables to the next line. So ENDL, then we'll say C out. How about status next? ENDL, same process with model and for sale. All right, let's display this. All right, so pay attention for the Boolean value of for sale. It actually came up as a 1, and that means true. If it was 0, that means false. Now, when we display variables, we can also display these variables along with some text as well. So let's say that we want to make some sort of chart where we display all this information for a car. Well, the first step to do that is that we'll want to write a string of what we want to display. So let's say that we want to display the word year and not the variable, perhaps a colon and then a space, and then we'll display whatever value is within year. However, compared to other programming languages, you have to add like a plus here to display the variable. However, in C++, you need to use the insertion operator. So that's one thing that's different. And this should go away in a moment. Yep. Okay, so that cleared up. So if you want to combine displaying variables and some text, you need to separate each of these with an insertion operator. So let's do the same with each of these variables here. So we'll say price, then use the insertion operator. So status, I believe that was new or used. So probably I'll put like new/used so it's more understandable. And this will just take a moment. So we'll say model, and then for sale. Actually, I think I'll say availability. I can never spell this word. Availability. It's probably wrong, but close enough. All right, so let's display this now. All right, so you can see that we displayed some text along with our variable for each of these lines, except I messed up spelling model and availability, so let me go and fix those, because it's actually going to bother me if I don't. Okay, that's a lot better. So we have like the year here, 2020. It's a price, $9,999, a new Mustang, availability 1, which also means true, 0 means false. Now I'm gonna take the next part of this video just to show you guys a few different tricks that we can do with variables. For example, we can reassign values later on in our program. Let's say that this car is no longer for sale. We can say for underscore sale, the name of this variable, now equals false. So when we display this, it's now going to show the updated value when it was last updated. So this should display 0 now. And take notice that I didn't have to declare what the data type of this variable is, because you only have to do that once. And if you declare this variable type once, you don't have to do it again. Also, it's possible to declare a variable and not assign it a value right away, in case like you want to assign it later. For example, we could just say for sale is going to be a Boolean variable, but we don't know what value we want to assign to it quite yet, so we can just declare a variable and not assign any value, and later on in our program, we can assign that value later on. One thing that you should be aware of when using variables that contain an integer or a decimal is that you can use these as if they were this number. And that means you can also use this for math functions. Let's say for our price, there's like a 10% discount. What we can do is we could say the price equals whatever this price currently is times 0.9. That would be the same as a 10% discount. And this price will actually be updated. So let's run this. And these are actually treated as numbers now. Like you can see, the new price is $8,999. Now with strings, you can also combine strings together. For example, let's say that we want a variable named make. So the make of this Mustang would be Ford. All right, so we have a make and a model. So we can also combine these together. So we could say perhaps string, how about car, equals make plus model. And let's display this car variable instead of model. So we could change this to car, and we will display the car variable now. So this should say Ford Mustang. All right, but see that it combined both of these words together and it doesn't have any space between them. So you also have to take that into account. So we could say make plus a space plus model equals car. And this would also be an option too if you want to do some separation. So it's kind of like our car, which is a string data type, is holding like a whole sentence now, it seems. So those are the fundamental uses of variables. They can store a value, but you have to list what data type they're storing, and they will behave as the value that they contain. And you can reuse these later on in your program for any purpose, and you can name these basically whatever you want, but there's a few keywords that are off limits. Now, please be aware that there are more data types than this. I went over only a few of the more basic ones, just so that we can get the hang of things. There's more if you look online. For example, with doubles, there's also these things called floats, which also hold decimal values. They're referred to as floating point numbers, but they use 32 bits of precision, whereas in doubles, have double that precision, 64 bits of precision, and it's usually better to use doubles over floats because they are more accurate, so people tend to use doubles over floats. So if you guys are looking for some practice, I'll post the source code in the comments down below, and why don't you guys fill in some variables here of a car that you would like, and post it in the comments down below. But yeah, that is everything you need to know to get started working with variables in C++. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.